G'day everyone, welcome to StudyTime's Level 2 Genetic Variation and Change Strategy video. I'm Hetty.
And I'm Mackenzie. And as the name suggests, this standard is really all about genetic variation.
It kind of breaks down into two main areas. So there's patterns of inheritance, which is all about genetic variation on more of an individual level. And there's also genetic variation within populations.
Yeah, so because most bio exams will be giving you three long answer questions, usually one of them will be on patterns of inheritance and two of them will be about genetic variation at the population level.
Well, if you take on the tips in this video, you'll be set to succeed in this exam.
Let's get into it. So, patterns of inheritance. This is almost always the first section, and this overarching topic has a bunch of things inside of it. So, this is things like independent assortment, segregation, crossing over, monohybrid inheritance, and with this we have to take into consideration things like codominance, incomplete dominance, multiple alleles, and lethal alleles. Then there's also dihybrid crosses, and with this you have to bear in mind the idea of linked genes. And then there's also, lastly, mutations as a new source of alleles. Now, getting down dihybrid crosses was something we would really recommend because 3 out of 4 years of the past exam papers actually started with a question on dihybrid crosses.
These questions will typically go on to ask you about describing meiosis and aspects of meiosis which decrease or increase genetic variation. When you're describing meiosis, you don't need to go into a lot of detail about what each stage involves, but it's a good idea to be able to draw a rough diagram of what each stage of meiosis has in it. You'll also want to be really familiar with things that decrease genetic variation in meiosis, so that's things like linked genes, and things that increase it, so that's things like crossing over and independent assortment. As a reminder, crossing over happens between homologous chromosomes during meiosis, and it creates new combinations of alleles. A really common mistake is to say that it creates new combinations of genes. Don't make this mistake, it's not true. You want to be really clear that you know the difference between chromosomes, alleles, and genes.
So this brings us to our second section of the standard, which is genetic variation at the population level. Now, questions under this topic can be selected from things like migration, genetic drift, natural selection, the founder effect or the bottleneck effect, and mutations as a new source of alleles. Now, bear in mind that mutations can be asked in either parts or sections of the standard.
Unlike questions on patterns of inheritance, which are usually broken down into sections, questions about genetic variation on a population level tend to be just one long excellence style answer with sort of achieved and merit sections nestled within it. Because of this, students often miss a key part of the question. To make sure this doesn't happen to you, try to answer the bullet points at the bottom of the question in order, tick them off when you're done, and if you think you need to come back to a bullet point to add something and you're not sure what to write, leave a space in your answer so you can see that you needed to come back to that. One of the questions about genetic variation on a population level is usually about natural selection, but it won't just be about natural selection, we'll usually combine it with some other concepts. For example, in the 2016 exam, it was combined with the effect of mutations, whereas in the 2017 exam, you're asked to talk about the effects of natural selection, mutation, and migration altogether on a population.
So one of our last tips for getting excellence in your question is to make sure that you're always bringing your discussion back to the context of the question. So it's not enough to say something like, the population genetic diversity was reduced due to the founder effect. What we need to be saying is, the current population on the Big South Cape Island has a low genetic diversity due to the founder effect. The difference here being that you're just including the context of the question in your answer.
This has been StudyTime's Level 2 Genetic Variation and Change Strategy video. Basically, just remember that this exam comes down to two main concepts, which is genetic variation in a population and genetic variation due to patterns of inheritance. We've covered a lot, but we haven't quite covered everything, so we'd really recommend checking out the past few years of exams to get a feel for what to expect.
Yeah, and also if you're still feeling a bit stuck, check out our walkthrough guides, and they're available free online or you can buy them in print with next day delivery, and they're designed to walk you through everything that you need to know for this standard.
Good luck!
Don't you beat me to it!